Kids come to the science place to discover the natural world in a new way. And when they're looking for bugs, there's no need to turn over a rock. They just head to Imaginature.
Imaginature is an area downstairs at the science place in our kids' place area. And it has, as you can see, a lot of kind of nature-themed decor. And we've got bees, we have bunnies, we have a budgie cage with little birds that are shown live on our website through a webcam. So Imaginature is one of our favorite spots.
The birds aren't the only ones on camera. The bees get their time in the spotlight too.
Our bees, we actually have a beehive that's indoors that allows bees to fly in and out of the science place and come back, and so you can see really up close and personal these bees and the way that they live. There's a camera that's pointing at the tube where someone can get a really up close television-ish view of a bee heading out to collect some pollen from a flower and do its general bee job.
Honeybees and any sort of bees have highly complex social behaviors. As a matter of fact, they are little societies that function as a whole. And within that society of bees, which we call a colony, which lives in a hive like the one you see behind me, we have many different social levels of bees which perform different functions for the colony. There's only one queen bee in every hive, and she produces the eggs that create all of the offspring that eventually make up all of the bees within that colony. Other classes or castes of bees are found in the hive. Worker bees are always female bees. They're never male. Male bees are called drone bees. When worker bees get older and more mature, they fly out of the hive and they do the pollinating. They gather pollen and nectar from plants. And they also guard the hive from other colonies. The male bee is called the drone bee, and the drone bee's purpose is actually to pollinate the queen. Sounds like a good job, except for the fact that every winter the drone bees get kicked out of the hive and usually end up dead. The science place is not only home to insects like bees, but also to arachnids like spiders.
We have a really special Peruvian pink-toe tarantula. The Latin name for Peruvian pink-toe is Arvicula urticans. She stays in a corner near an exhibit called the Spider Maze. The Spider Maze is a fun experience that people can actually know what it's like to be potential spider food. There's a spider in the middle of our maze that's more like a spider web. And the goal of the experience is to step into the spider maze and not touch any of the web, because spiders can sense the vibration of their webs with their feet, and that tends to alert them that there's a meal on its way.
The goal with the spider's web is for you to reach the inside of the web without setting off any of the bells. The bells being the vibrations which would tell the spider to come and eat you. So I'm going to try my luck at the spider maze right now. You can see, it's not quite as easy as it looks. Spiders, I hate spiders. Bugs that sting and bite may have had bad reputations, but the science place helps give kids a new appreciation for their buggy pals.
Cool, but we really hope to show children that some animals, even if they seem kind of creepy, are very important and shouldn't necessarily be feared. A lot of kids, I think, have come away from here thinking, I'm gonna look up a little bit more about these bugs because they're really interesting, and maybe we have some future entomologists or insect scientists coming out of here every day.